welcome back to the Unapologetic Truth with Tanisha Brown. Today I have here with me Margarita Paz Pedro and Keith Scott, not only beloved friends and family of mine, but extremely awesome artists. So we're going to talk to them today about some of the things that they have going in our city and abroad in the state of New Mexico. So we're going to jump and dive right in. Margarita. So a little bit about us. Marge, we met several years ago. Margarita is the best friend to my younger sister, Chandra. So she has been around for ages. And through that connection, we obviously became very good friends. And Marge is our artist extraordinaire. She is a ceramic artist, an artist, a teacher, a painter. You just got your master's, correct?
Yes.
Tell me what you got your master's in.
So I got my master's in fine arts with the emphasis of studio arts in integrative practice from the Institute of American Indian Arts.
Okay, American Indian Arts. Tell me a little bit about that.
It's a four-year, actually now, they have a couple of master's programs, but primarily serving Indigenous students from all over, including Canada and beyond the Americas. One thing that's really unique about my program, I was like in the first cohort of the program.
Okay.
And so they have all Indigenous faculty.
Okay.
And mentors, and you go to any higher ed institution and you have like one among a thousand. So
wow.
That felt really special.
That is really special. That is really special, especially because you were able to obtain your master's amongst all of the other projects and things that you were doing. I remember quite often going on to our social media pages and not having to wonder where you've been or what you've been doing or why we haven't seen you, because you have been just all over. You guys do predominantly a lot of your projects where? Are they balanced out or?
As far as arts together, or mainly in Albuquerque, the ones that we've done. We did do one here in Las Cruces.
Okay.
In 2017.
And that is the one that is
at the Parks and Rec Administration Building, the Mondi Castaneda, I believe it's called, on Hadley.
Okay.
So it's by the Aquatic Center.
Okay, that one was, I do remember we went out to that one. That one is, oh, they all are gorgeous exhibitions of their talent. They didn't just go out there as artists and put things up on the wall. You guys even had volunteers. You brought kids in, local kids in, for an internship to be a part of that, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
To kind of just dig and see where they, where their artistic even passion or talent lies, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so I do remember that. And all of these projects that we're talking about today, I am going to try to do my best to do a reel so that everyone can see what they've done around the city of Las Cruces, and in Albuquerque and in Laguna, correct? Or haven't made it there yet?
Not yet,
okay.
So much.
You've just done a lot of your photography there,
yes.
Right? Okay, yeah. Okay, so I want to reach over here and, nope, this one right here. What is this, Marge, SWC?
So it stands for Southwest Contemporary. This is a new magazine that just came out September 1st. It's the fall and winter edition, and they did a call for artists with a theme called Medium and Support. And so I entered, and I've entered like a few times, and this is the first time I got in. So.
Okay, so you were chosen to do something, correct?
Well, my work fit within their...
The Medium and Support.
Yeah, within the theme that they put out, so it was exciting.
Yay!
Really cool.
And all the photos are done by Keith. He's like the main guy that makes all my work look amazing.
There you go. Dynamic duo, you guys. Truly a dynamic duo. We talked about a lot of those things. I want to get to your ceramic art because for me, it just, that's my jam right here. So we are going to look at some of the things that Marge did. This is just a cup, correct?
Yes.
It could be anything though. but I mean, just beautifully made. Like I am not an expert in art. The things that I see, I just decide in my mind if it awakes a emotion or a sense that it is, you know, valuable enough to awake someone else's senses and emotions. So this is one of her pieces. This is one of her pieces. You can just see like the multi-dimensional things that are going on here. And I don't know if I'm using the correct art terms, but they're going to forgive me for that. So then we have some things back here. Look at that. I'm just completely amazed. Now this one is a bowl, my very first bowl that you made me, correct?
Mm-hmm.
And there's going to be more to come. She just doesn't know that. She is not aware of that part of it yet. Tell me about this. This is heavy, but it was beautiful.
So in addition to your own functional works, which is what these are.
Okay.
You can use them, you can eat out of them, you can drink out of them, you could put them in the dishwasher, all that.
Mm-hmm.
You can even bake dips.
Okay.
Bake things in them.
And display them as works of art.
I also do ceramic tile murals, and so this is just like a mini version of a mosaic that I made for my mom, and I started doing this ceramic photo transfer technique,
mm-hmm.
where I kind of, it's trial and error, but I can transfer photos onto clay and then seal it in and it's there.
Okay.
And so this was like one of the first of them that I was able to figure out.
Okay.
And this was already 5 years ago.
Okay.
A while
Sorry
back.
Guys, I was not holding it all the way straight so that you can see that, but hopefully you can see the actual photo that is here. And this is...
These are my grandparents.
Grandparents.
Yeah.
That's just awesome. We are always trying to find new and different ways, and with social media and all of the electronic sources of keeping our photos and mm-hmm. things like that, that's kind of 2015 type thing. But when you can take a photo of someone that's important to you
mm-hmm.
and ingrain it and make it part of something that you know is going to last much longer, that you can put up anywhere,
mm-hmm.
it just kind of takes that emotional attachment and connection to that photo mm-hmm. a step higher. Thank you for that.
Mm-hmm.
You have also started doing commissions as well, correct?
Yes.
Okay, so I saw a large commission that you did. I believe it was for maybe an organization in Albuquerque?
It was for the city of Albuquerque. I did they give awards to artists every year
mm-hmm.
as a artist they want to highlight that have been working in their craft for years.
Okay.
So it's called Creative Bravos, and it's through city of Albuquerque, and they gift them an artwork as a congratulations.
Okay.
I did it last year, and mm-hmm. then they asked me again to do it this year, so I made 28 cups
mm-hmm.
for them to give to those artists.
Okay. We will certainly be using some of that same art as swag bags and gifts for future visitors as well, in addition to my dishes for my house. Okay, so thank you so much for that, Marge. It is always an extra added treat when you have a family member. I'm sure all of you know who is extremely talented. And with these two here, we are double blessed, and our lives are doubly enriched by their presence in our lives on each and every day. They travel with us quite often on all of our family vacations, which have included Cancun a few times, and this past year, Jamaica. And what that means for us, in ways of a blessing, is you can't ever erase the memories that we create, right? Mm. But we especially can't erase them when we have such a good photographer in our midst that can, this is a book that, this is Cancun, right?
Yeah.
This is a book that Keith did for us, and he has done another book for others as well. Now, this was in last year, and what he has done for us and what is so important is we talk about not being able to erase those memories, but because he knows each and every one of us, and he makes it a point to know all of his clients and customers, he uses our nuances, our personality traits, and things that he knows about us to capture a moment 10 times better than you would just catch a regular moment. If I take a photo and we're on vacation, it doesn't capture the true essence of the time that we're having, of the memories that we're sharing, of the laughter that is, you know, commencing all over the place. I mean, it's usually 10 plus of us, and he never fails to capture all of us in a moment where we didn't even know he was there. We didn't even know he was watching. I won't say lurking, I will say watching. But he catches all of those moments, and then after the vacation, it's almost like you build our excitement and our anxiety one more, that one last yeah. time, because you give us something like this, or you shoot us a link with all of our photos. Mm. And I know for me, when I click on that link and I start opening pictures, I'm like, where was he at? How did he catch this?
That's where the long lens comes in.
Yes, I would imagine so. And we're talking about not just a long lens, we're talking about this guy packs his drone, and has gotten aerial shots of our vacations and our family moments. More importantly, he just captured my parents' 50th anniversary renewal of their vows in Jamaica, and it was awesome to see. It was awesome to go back and relive those moments, and that's just what we're able to do. But you don't just do photography, do you?
No.
Okay, you are a digital creator.
Yeah.
Graphic artist and a painter as well.
Yeah.
So we really do have the dynamic duo. I know that you guys see my shirt that I am wearing. I know that you see these other shirts here. I'm going to pick them up. Keith is also the owner of his own clothing company, Box Robot Company, that was established in...
Let's see, I think officially 2019.
Okay.
But, you know, before then, we were always creating stuff.
Yep. He has even an ambassador that he uses for all of his new line of his clothes.
Yep.
His name is Tony Brown.
Where's you guys will all come on in.
You will all... We're going to leave him outside right now. But... you guys will get to meet him shortly, trust me. But he always, you always look out for him. You look out for all of us, but because as his ambassador, he, you know, gets to be able to get some of the first looks at things.
Yeah.
And it always is something exciting. I mean, there has been decals,
yeah.
Shirts, sweatshirts.
Patches, stickers.
Beanies.
Yeah, beanies.
You did some things with some skateboards too, right?
Yeah, we did a few skateboards.
Yeah, just everything that you can...
put our logo on, pretty much.
Yeah, but yeah. I'm telling you, if you're driving around town and you see this robot, know it's the Box Robot Company, and Keith and Margarita keep us all covered in the greatest... and most up-to-date wear, urban wear, whatever we want to call it, photography, art. I mean, it's just all-encompassing. And I know that I have been around in town and have family in Albuquerque too. And I'll, you know, mention some of the things that you have done. And they've seen the artwork.
Yeah.
And they know that it's there. They mention things like it being, you know, kind of a just a little reminder all's not bad, all is not lost. I know that I've driven down the street at times and looked up and saw one of your sunflowers on one of the buildings and thought, that's my girl. And not only that, but then, you know what? There's some sun to the day. There's a bright shine on the day. It kind of just moves the clouds out of my view sometimes during the day. So thank you for that. What else am I missing? Once we put the video up, you guys, we will have all of their social media handles, Keith's website to go and buy some of this awesome box robot art, and decal stickers. You've heard it. You name it, he's got it, and he can get that for you. You have also started dibbling and dabbling and making logos and things like that, right?
Yeah.
Okay. He's also put a lot of these important photos for us on canvas. Mm-hmm. You have done some animations for us as well. All of these things, again, guys, I'm going to do a reel so that you can really appreciate it and see it. Talking about it is not enough. Seeing these items when there is a barrage of other things that they have done for the city of Las Cruces, the city of Albuquerque, and other areas does not do it justice. So please make sure that you check out those links and that reel and my bio. Tell me what else you guys have coming up. I know you probably have some events or something coming up. Mr. Keith, what we got going on?
Let's see. Right now I'm working with offices of Laguna Learning.
Okay.
And we're kind of taking photographs of, there's a Carice dictionary where it's like translated into English words.
Okay.
So we're taking all those photographs for the department.
And Carice is the language spoken in Laguna.
Okay.
So
okay.
It's the native language of that area.
Okay. So you're getting ahead of things and you're making sure that that language is not lost.
Right? Yeah. That's their whole goal is to preserve it, have people learn it, and, you know, for future generations.
Okay. See, this is about to make me emotional, guys, because not only because they're friends and more so family than they are anything, it is important because all of us have something in our culture that we stop and we think, oh, I can't appreciate it enough because I don't know enough about it. Or so much of it has been lost in, you know, just the changing of the times, the changing of the guard, the new generations doing things much differently, reinventing their own trends and things like that. So you lose a lot of the things that made us who we are.
Mm-hmm.
And for you guys to invest in saying this will not be lost is much more valuable than even the words that you can find to describe it. So what does that, are there going to be preserved somewhere? What are you guys doing with all of those photos?
They're gonna use them in websites, they can use them in like booklets.
Mm-hmm.
And just, I think there's gonna be a ton of stuff that they're gonna unleash, like illustrations, coloring books.
Okay.
And just put everybody's minds together and, you know, just get everything out. And
just kind of like marketing of, or not, marketing's probably not, mass sharing of.
To make sure everybody has access to it. So it's a major project. It's massive.
It absolutely is. And other cultures and other of us should be immensely blessed by being able to take a piece of that and just know. Like, you don't have to know to copy it. You don't have to know to... You have to know for the intrinsic value of how important it is to me to know where my brothers and sisters came from.
Yeah.
Where my family, you know, where you originated from and what makes you guys you.
Yeah,
so,
exactly.
Uniquely you. And that is something that cannot be replaced, can't be duplicated, and that is a big project. So, you know, I really can appreciate the things that you guys are doing. And what else we got going on? Oh, I didn't even mention that he also does photography for senior pics.
Family photos.
Family photos. We've done.
I'm getting into sports photography now, so.
Oh yeah, we got right on time.
So Christian's gonna start playing, so maybe.
Yes, Christian Brown is definitely gonna start playing football. He's done basketball, but that is something too. So if you're looking for family photos, senior photos, sports photos, any of those photos, wedding photos,
anniversary
photos, which you'll be doing for us soon, then hey, you guys need to make sure that you find out how to find this guy. Equally so for Marge, if you are looking to update dishes, multifunctional dishes in your home, artwork, things that need to be done in the city. I know that they're working on a lot of projects and cruises. City of Lost Cruises. Don't let her get away from you guys. And actually the both of them, because you guys have worked on those things together. Yeah. So that's always been, you know, my fascination is that there's so much art and talent in your home that, and little Solana, their daughter, mm-hmm. I hope I'm not out of place, but she's my niece, so is already exhibiting that she shares that passion.
She's very crafty.
Yes, she is. I mean, she has been, more recently so, she made Chandra, my younger sister, a birthday card.
Yeah.
And you can already see that she's sharing your talents and passions because she took what she knew about her Auntie Chandra and she made her birthday card. That's quite funny. Hopefully Auntie Chandra will share it with us. But we've been on vacation and she's had her own camera. She had that nice new little Polaroid camera that she was taking photos of. So without knowing it, you have already passed on not only the talents, but the passion that you guys have that is culturally driven, that is just artistically driven. And I know that I speak for my entire rest of the family when we say that we are blessed and immensely grateful and thankful for that you guys that are part of our journey, our family, and our lives, and the things that we're about to do are going to be great.
Yeah. Aww,
again, so you guys, if you have any questions at all, I'm going to see if Keith and Marge will be available later on for a Q&A session. They will certainly be joining us again as their projects get bigger, they get busier, and they get more famous. I'll have to pull them back in, but thank you for joining myself, Marge Paz Pedro, and Keith Scott on the Unapologetic Truth. Yeah.